It is I, the Dalek Emperor, and welcome to another Dalek cast. Today we are doing once again some more interesting levels of questions. So, let's observe them now, shall we? Where's the community post? Oh, there it is. Good. Now, let us begin now. Okay, so our first question comes from Jamie Alberding. It is the Shadow Vessel from Babylon 5 versus the Borg's iconic ship. Which of these two different sci-fi alien capital ships do you think is more terrifying and more deadlier? Well, let's have a look first at the Babylon 5 ship. Now, let's have a look. It looks kind of like a spider. If I do say so myself, and I think, doesn't the Borg ship look like a cube? I have to say, I think the Borg ship is more terrifying, of course. Okay, so we have some. We apparently don't have any video games or video ideas for today, but we do have some reactions, so let's begin observing it then. Okay, viewers, here is the first of many videos. Now, this video was made by Dalek Ray and is a recreation, is an, yet another recreation scene of Big Finish Productions' video of Blood of the Daleks. Now, yes, this is the exact same scene where the Daleks meet the other Daleks on the planet of Red Rocket Rising. Now, these are the same, these include Imperial drones and defense drones. The defense drones, in particular, from Revolution of the Daleks. All credit will go to Big Finish as well. And Dalek Rain, let's begin.
Identify yourself.
Identify.
We are the ultimate evolution. Our creator has sent us to greet you.
You are the Daleks on Red Rocket Rising.
Yes, our creator made us by studying.
Yes, you are the Daleks created on Red Rocket Rising.
Your technology. He sent out a signal for you to come and assist in the birthing of a new species. Daleks, you are welcome.
I see.
Scans confirm presence of genetic impurities.
They are impure.
We are all Daleks.
No.
You are not Daleks. You represent a deviation from the purity of the Dalek bloodline.
But our creator summoned you, and you came.
Incorrect. You will be exterminated. You all are impure.
And we received the signal from Martez. That is what...
As well as the Imperial faction, they too are impure.
We deflected the asteroid to destroy this planet.
Excellent.
Understand? They must be eradicated.
They must be eradicated. Exterminate!
Why would you do this? We are Daleks. We are the same. You were summoned to bring life to our species.
For your species are mutants. There can be only
extermination.
Exterminate!
Yes, exterminate them all. Okay. So, the next video we have in store is Goth Rocker. Here we go, from Warhammer, apparently. Uh, I think this is a scene which was, I think this is a scene that was I think it's a scene that was made by Warhammer. I think the developers of Warhammer, I presume, and apparently the by the looks of things, it looks like it's a comic, I presume, a comic strip or something, and I think this is made about 2 weeks ago, made by Warhammer, all credit will go to him, all credit will go to the channel Warhammer. I presume it's the same one who made the games of Warhammer 40k. Let's observe then, all credits. I've no idea what golf rockers are, but... Or this area we go is... Anyway, let's have a look. Oh, it's a song, right. This might be copyrighted. This is a Christmas song, I see. This is made 2 weeks ago. Ah, yes. Have a, rocking Warhammer Christmas, thank you. Yes, indeed, I liked that. Thank you, Warhammer. Yes, I enjoyed that video. This might be copyrighted. We might not be able to play this. So I'm going to have to do my usual, removing the audio from this video, sadly, from this reaction. Anyway, let us move on then now. We have a lot of Adam Walker VFX videos to look at. So apparently each one of these videos made by Adam Walker, must not get confused with Alan Walker, who's a very good remix dubstep person. Yes, apparently he's made a bunch of title sequences. And apparently the first three are from the Peter Cushing universe, yes. The one where the Daleks are, let's just say, incompetent and keep blowing themselves up and falling into volcanoes because of their idiocy. That one. You're not even canon. Yes. This is the intro that wasn't even considered canon from the two movies that weren't also considered canon. Anyway, regardless if they're canon or not, let's see how they are easily remade in 4K. Not even called Doctor Who. These names are entirely inaccurate. Also, wasn't Susan older and Barbara wasn't? Yes, I miss the days when Susan wasn't related to, the Doctor. I miss the days where Barbara wasn't related to the Doctor, and the Doctor was just called the Doctor, not Doctor Who. Who the heck calls himself Doctor Who? Sounds like a New York name. Sounds like it's a name given to writers who do not know what Doctor Who is. But then again, despite my grievances and hatred for the Doctor Who spin-offs, let's just say that, let's just call them spin-offs because they aren't even classed as actual Doctor Who episodes. Nothing can be compared to the real thing. But then again, I think the writers of the BBC have stated that this video, that these movies aren't canon, which is good, because it'd be weird if Barbara and Susan were related, if Barbara was also related to the Doctor, and Ian was just some weird boyfriend, apparently. And he didn't even say the name TARDIS right. People worked on this, didn't they? Well, that I think I know who is behind these movies. Warner Brothers. So yes, behind this. Anyway, yes, we have another video made by Adam Walker. And this one, apparently is the same video here. So, it's called Dalek Invasion of Earth 21. It's not even called Daleks Invasion of Earth 21. It's called Doctor... They got the name wrong. It's Doctor Who, The Dalek Invasion of Earth. Come on, really? No, I don't want to watch the Disney thing yet. Anyway, enough of these advertisements. Time to react to the second Adam Walker video. I'll credit go to him. Let's observe. Oh dear. It's the second Doctor Who movie video thing. Right. Also, the TARDIS didn't make a noise. So that's entirely inaccurate. British Line Films, you are next. Just kidding. I don't want to destroy them. Regardless if I think they're terrible. They're inaccurate Doctor Who movies. And they don't give us much representation. That does not mean that I shall exterminate British Line Films. Peter Cushing again. It's not even called that. Yes, Bernard Cribbins is in this one. Yes. Wilfred Mott, of course. But apparently he was a police officer in that one. And, kind of took the role of Ian in this. Kind of basically, basically had to fill in the shoes of the other actor who played Ian in the previous Peter Cushing spin-off movie, because apparently they didn't really look at the episode properly. If I'm correct, in the Dalek Invasion of Earth, in Chesterton, Susan and Barbara travelled with the Doctor to 2150. Not just a police officer and his granddaughter Susan. Also, in that episode, in that movie, why didn't Peter Cushing leave Susan behind like he did in the in the actual show? Shouldn't it be like, I don't know, more accurate to the show? Also, the intro's wrong. Oh. I see. Television serial. Thank you. Yes, I do prefer the original Doctor Who theme. Don't know what this this theme is trying to be. Is it trying to... Is it trying to be Star Wars? Is it trying to be Doctor Who? No, not Star Wars. Is it trying to be James Bond, or is it trying to be Doctor Who? Okay, so this video, video apparently is a yet another Peter Cushing, it's a concept for the third, but not released, Peter Cushing, Doctor Who. That's right, there's a third one as well. There's a third one! Yes, exactly, a third one. This one's based around the chase, whole Mary Celeste, ship crashing, escaping Dracula's castle. Oh, God, I swear, if they remade the chase, they would make the Dracula scene even more goofy than the original. And, yes, but, yeah. But, yeah, apparently the Lone Daleks in this one. Okay, I have to see this now. I did all the renders for the TARDIS effects. We also did the voices. He played Blue Dalek and played the Gold Dalek leader. I see. So without further ado, viewers, all credit go to Adam Walker. Let's observe. Let's see what this is about. Yes? Adam Walker, the effects. Actually, this looks kind of good. They made the TARDIS more accurate. But yeah, I'm thinking the reason why there wasn't a third one is because, well, I think Peter Cushing was doing Star Wars as Grand Moff Tarkin.
Approaching the planet.
Capture the TARDIS!
At radius. Its commander, Doctor Who, and his associates must be preparing to land.
Excellent!
We cannot escape! Our time ship will soon follow them! We shall pursue them throughout time and space!
Excellent!
Exterminated!
Yes, exterminate them all!
Exterminated!
Victory will be ours! This is even more Austin Powersy and James Bondy by the minute. It even looks less like a Doctor Who intro now. Daleks versus Mechanoids. The eccentric Doctor Who. Jim Dale. what Christopher Lee was supposed to be in that movie? Okay, yes. Wait. Christopher Lee was supposed to be in that movie? Right, I'm sold. Yes, 10 out of 10. Would watch, most definitely. This feels like a James Bond intro, still. I don't know why, but I still see it as a James Bond intro, and even looks more James Bondy. Why didn't... What was the purpose in making these Peter Cushing movies? That's not what the TARDIS makes! What? Oh, I pressed the wrong button! Ow! I pressed the wrong button! I apologize for this! Anyway, so, we have two last videos, and they are based in Doctor Who, the actual Doctor Who universe, not whatever Peter Cushing was trying to do here.
I'm being cute.
No, I don't want BNQ, thank you! Go away now! Okay, right. So this video... So, this title sequence is based off the Paul McGann Big Finish Doctor Who, yes. That one. The real Doctor Who movie. One from a real Doctor Who movie. And not the spin-off Doctor Who movie. The real one. Yes, see, this is the fake one. This is the real one. Yes. One where the Doctor is in America trying to escape the Master Eric Roberts. And apparently this is for his Big Finish audio productions, basically. Yes, this one looks better. This one is excellent. Robert Sherman. I would have loved to see, like, live-action Paul McGann Doctor Who's. And maybe based in the Time War, but then again, John Hurt is dead, so I doubt he'll be able to do anything now. Because he's dead. Anyway, we have another video, which is basically another title sequence called Doctor Who Beware Fan Series Title. Let's observe all credits. If this is the 14th Doctor's theme, I want it to be! This theme definitely feels like it could be a 14th Doctor theme for David Tennant. seconds. What the double treason? Doctor Who? Symphony of the Daleks. Oh, I see. First fan-made of the series. I see. Really? Well, I definitely consider watching that. Anyway, it is time to end now. Let us end now. So anyway, my fellow subjects, I hope you enjoyed these videos today. This video today. And if you did, well, remember to subscribe for more, and I'll see you all in the next video then.